Join our hosts as they step aboard the Stamas 31T Aventura, a yacht-inspired center console built for fishing in offshore conditions with ease. The Stamas 31T Aventura has an overall length of 31 feet 7 inches, a beam of 10 feet 4 inches, and a max horsepower rating of 700. Engineered to tame blue water, she has a draft of 19 inches, a dead rise of 18 degrees, a dry weight of 7,800 pounds, and a fuel capacity of 276 gallons. Now, let's hear more from our hosts.
Well, guys, we're on the Stamas 31 Aventura today, and you know, one of the things that we normally are filming these boats in the summertime, and we hardly ever get a sloppy day to test the boat out. Well, today, that's not gonna be the case. The wind's blowing pretty good. It looks like it's pretty rough offshore, and you know, we're gonna really get a chance to see what the Stamas can do in the slop.
Listen, weather's really not concerning me today because walking up here, this looks like a lorry boat. I've got all the comfort features I need and plenty of fishing room.
Let me tell you what this boat I think is going to be for us, a 2020 fishing machine. Think about how much crews have changed. And from feeling that breeze coming through the inlet this morning, I think we're going to be glad we're on a Stamas.
Now, the hull design on this boat brings a little bit more beam to the boat than you typically see on a center console fishing boat. This boat is 31 feet 7 by 10'4". Now that's a wide beam. The boat also weighs over 6,000 pounds. You're gonna feel that when you get out in some rough weather on this boat. Absolutely, you're gonna feel like you've got a boat onto you. But more importantly than that is the fact that that takes nothing away from the performance of the boat when it comes to fuel. At 30 miles an hour, this boat is gonna see 1.76 miles per gallon fuel efficiency, which is really, really good numbers. The boat will top out at 54 miles an hour and still give you 1 mile to the gallon, which is nearly unheard of. That's really good numbers for a boat of this caliber. The 31T also features the three-sided glass enclosure, which I'm a huge fan of. I like this design. This boat gives you great airflow when you're at the helm. It's got a really big helm display. It's just really exceptionally viewable. Now, it's really clear that Stamas has gone to great lengths to improve the aesthetic on these boats, and this 31T Aventura's got a great look. You're gonna see flowing lines, you're gonna see a break in the shear line created by the use of the rub rail. More importantly, you're gonna see a lot of really bright finish work on the inside of the boat too. Everything is high polished, lots of beautiful upholstery. So it's really combining the best of both worlds and having a beautiful boat that's practical to fish on.
Up at the bow, we had our U-shaped seating with really plush cushions, but inside the combing boasters were your actual cup holders. So they were out of the way, you couldn't see them. Under the bow seating, you have your storage compartments on the port and starboard side. But that's not all that this bow has to offer. Let's talk about this centerpiece. You can not have it at all, so you can walk around and fish. And my favorite part, you can pop it up as a table, sit around, have booth-style lunch. In the console, you add a head, a freshwater sink, and a really large mirror, and plenty of storage space. I love a good bait prep station, and the Stamas did a great job today on theirs. And I had a freshwater sink right there. So again, best of both worlds. You can do your bait prep, clean it off, and turn it into a little galley.
Not only can she handle big water, but you've got stern seating that places you directly in front of the live well in the helm station. Now, why is that important? Because it's got a clear window to it. The most valuable asset you've got if you're going live bait fishing is, of course, your live bait. Sounds like a little thing, not if you're serious about your blue water fishing. This is a boat that can wear a few different hats. All right, fold down that rear transom seat, and she is a hardcore fishing boat to lean up against to fight a big fish from the stern. Comes time to chill out a little bit, just put that big hat on, flip that seat up, and you've got room for three people to sit comfortably across your transom. You know what? I don't know what we ever did before tackle trays. This one not only had a great tackle station, it had it in the right place on a boat to keep your tackle good for months at a time. You've got a massive live well in the transom, you've got the one in the helm station, you can store all the live baits you ever want to store on the Aventura 31. I don't want my rods left out in the weather, and I don't want them left out for everybody to see. That's why I like those two boxes in the floor. They're insulated, they can be a fish box or they can be a rod box. You can stack them below the deck where nobody can see them and nobody knows they're there. Having that big fish box on the transom really works out well for me. I like to be able to gaff a fish and slide him in there And I don't want a box that's so huge that it takes 300 pounds of ice to cool it down. That Aventura fish box is good for me.
You know what, Rick? I ran this boat all day, and you know, every Stamas I've ever run has never failed to impress me with not only how rugged they are, but how stable they are. I mean, this boat with a 10-foot, 4-inch beam, it was pretty sloppy there today, and for sure, we were comfortable the entire time.
You guys are right. This was sturdy, stable, and a great day of fishing.
I'm gonna tell you, I think John Stamas is right. The family's been saying we've been overbuilding boats for over 60 years, and they've certainly done that with this 31 Aventura.